Okay, how's everybody doing today? Got some gravy today. Got some front control arms and struts for a 2015 Jetta. Kind of sucks because I have to take the springs off and the strut mounts off and swap them over, but it'll be all right. Okay, 24.
12 point.
Got a triple square. Triple square. Little stubby. Half inch.
Snap on.
Oh, I'm gonna take the lower control arm off first. Okay, I'll take out the
18 bolt here on the lower control arm.
Now we got the 18 back here. Reckon that's 18 too. Okay, then we got three 16s here for the lower ball joint. The heck's going on?
Huh? What? Oh, is that on the building? Did you burn it or anything?
I set that off once like 3 years ago, but I had a lot of smoke. I don't know how to shut it off. Okay, well, I guess that was a fire alarm. I'm assuming that's what it was, because I set it off once like 3 years ago, burning out a bushing or something. Had a lot of smoke in there and it went off. It's only the second time I've ever heard it go off. But he didn't have any smoke back there, so I don't know what was going on. I just killed the whole power to the whole building to get it to shut off, so I don't know. Alright, so now we got the three bolts out here and two bolts there for the lower control arm out. that's gravy. Definitely a little bad. Boink. Okay. All right. So now I need to take off the sway bar link on the top, and then I think I can just pull this out and kind of let this knuckle hang off of the outer tie rod end. Maybe hang it up or something. Boy, if they would have gave me quick stress, this would have been super gravy. Okay, it looks like an 18. H5 blue point. Yep. Then I got my, like, I don't know, you used to call them all thread, where you can put all thread through there. I don't know what they're called. Little gear wrench. Let that loose. Then you can just take your quarter inch ratchet.
Thank you.
Here on the axle, so not pulling on anything. I think I like it better with it. I break line around it. Yeah. But you don't want to put pressure on that brake line. Let's see what it looks like. Yeah, I know we don't want pressure on the brake line, but I'm gonna move that around there just a little bit of good. Or actually, let me get a bungee cord. Okay, so we will tie this over here around the tape frame mount. We don't have any pressure. Brake hose. Just find something suitable to hook to. Now I don't have any pressure on my brake hose at all, so. At Online Mechanic Tips, JT. Big old brake hose, hanging the caliper off the brake hose discussion. But I agree, you do not wanna, I have let some aluminum calipers hang, you know, but if you got a big old heavy steel caliper, my goodness, it's crazy to let that hang. Okay, so now all I gotta do is let it down, or don't even really have to let it down. Take out my top three bolts out of the strut. Or 13. Yep. strut comes right out of there. I just have to go over to the strut press, pull off that mount, and change the spring over. Okay, now to change the strut mount over and the spring. Put my vice grips on the shaft, buzz off this 21 millimeter. Okay. Grab me another strut. Now, I know you probably shouldn't grab the new strut with the vice grip. Push down the little bumper, and I am going to grab it at the very top. It's never going to travel to that spot, so it will be fine. Push my bumper back up in there. And now we just stick our strut back up in there. headlight back out.
This is what I use for a headlight, stream light, or no, coast. It's coast. So now I got some bright light. So I got two of them that way. One will usually last, you know, over half a day, but then I gotta swap her out.
All right. Now, you know, most people probably would have took this knuckle all the way off. And I wouldn't say you're wrong. Make it easier to slide up on there. I'm gonna put my chisel back in there. Open that gap up a little bit. So that slides up on there. Chisel out of there. Now, put our axle back in. Get our wiggle back in at the top. Put our wheel speed sensor back in its spot here. One. And then we need to tighten up our sway bar link. One time, it's been years back, when I first got this big boy here, I did break off a sway bar link. So, you don't want to give it too many ugga-duggas with that. All right.
We got suede on the tire, we got bolts tight on the top on the strut. We have our wire back in its spot. It goes for the wheel speed sensor. We have the brake line where it goes with the clip in. Now we just need to put the lower control arm on. Back in first. There we go. Put my 18 millimeter in right here on the front of the control arm. Get my 18 millimeter wrench. Tighten up this back one. Okay, now I've just got my 3/16 left. Be careful with these too, you could easily snap these off. If you got this big one. And just always, no matter what you're doing, always, always, go back over everything. All you gotta do is lay your eyes on it. I tighten these, I tighten that, I tighten that, I tighten that, I tighten that, I put that hose back in and the wire back in, done. All right, so for the passenger side, all I have to do is put the tire back on. Then I have to do the driver's side. Okay, there is one thing different on the driver's side lower control arm from the passenger side. So this bolt here that goes in, you can't get it out because of the oil pan, or well, the transmission pan. So you just take out these 216 millimeters right here. Torque bar mount right there. Take out them two bolts, 16 millimeters. Right here on the transmission. See how far that engine flexes forward? Quite a bit. Okay, so I just got my power bar between the K-frame and the transmission here. Let's pull that back, pull the power bar back. Bolt comes right out. So that's the only thing different between the two sides. If you can see, I am sweating up a storm. So reason being, because I have to shut all my fans off when I record because there's too much background noise. So I'm going to shut the video off here. All I have to do is do the same thing to the other side. So it might be kind of boring since you are just watching me do this side to do the same thing again. So, but I do want to thank everybody for watching. Anybody that has subscribed, I greatly appreciate it. And I hope you all have a blessed day.